A British woman has gone viral after sharing her shocking weight loss transformation online. 25-year-old Liv Ralph dropped 32 kilos. Some of her followers found it hard to believe she was even the same person. She says there's been a significant change in the way people treat her, especially men.
And Liv Ralph joins us now from London. Liv, you've been on quite the journey, I think we can say. Can you tell us what life was like for you before your transformation?
It was more of a struggle. I was still happy. Like, I was never really bullied or anything, but I was constantly worried about my weight and I was a bit self-conscious about it. And I felt like I was always the ugly fat friend and I never really got taken seriously by people because of that, really, yeah. So it was a lot worse, but it was all right.
You've spoken a lot about what has surprised you in terms of the differences in day-to-day life and how people treat you. What surprised you the most?
Probably people take you a lot more seriously. And I think people are just more willing to help you, like out in public. I know that sounds really strange, but in public, say, people would be more willing to like help you carry your bags and stuff like that. And just overall, I think subconsciously people are just more kind towards you.
And how about in terms of dating? Have men treated you differently?
Yeah, definitely. That's probably the main difference, I think, is before I was kind of seen as like, as I said, like the fat friend, the jolly one. And I was always, you know, one of the lads would drink beer and stuff like that. And they never really, they saw me more as a friend. And then now it's sort of shifted a little bit more into they see me more as a lady, if you know what I mean.
And Liv, you've said that because of all this, you feel as though your worth is now tied to your appearance and that you never stop obsessing about it. It must be a hard way to live.
Yeah, no, it is. I think before I cared about my appearance, but not as much as I do now. Like, I think as the weight went down, my, I wouldn't say obsession, but the way I feel about my appearance just completely changed. Like before, I wouldn't really care what I wore or how my hair was, and I'd go out to a club and I wouldn't wear makeup, whereas now it's like if I'm going to the pub, I make sure I've got my eyelashes on, I got my hair done. I think that's because it's sort of tied to going from someone who was seen as ugly before and then someone that's, you know, seen as not that ugly anymore, if you know what I mean. It's kind of, it's hard not to care about what you look like because you feel like every part of you is completely tied to your appearance. It's just something that I've, because even the way, like I said, the way people treat you and the way people are more kind towards you and you get more attention from males and stuff like that, it's hard not to obsess about the way you look, I think, especially in with social media and stuff like that, yeah.
And with this changed mindset, do you find now that perhaps you might be almost unconsciously judging other heavier people now that you've lost the weight?
No, not really. I don't think so. I don't really see weight. I kind of look at myself and I look at my own weight quite a lot. But in other people, I never have and I never will. I've not really noticed weight on other people. I think I don't know why that is. It might just be me as a person or because I was bigger before, but I probably care about my own weight more than anyone else's.
You just bully yourself like I bully myself.
Exactly. It's hard not to it's so strange how you can just go on your phone and within a couple of seconds, you see some of the most beautiful women in the world on social media, on TikTok, on Instagram. So it's hard not to be like that, I think. Yeah.
Liv, I guess, do you think as a society we place too much emphasis on our bodies or physical appearance in general?
I mean, before we had it with supermodels in magazines, and you know, you see those magazine titles where it's like, oh, so-and-so on the beach, they look like a whale. You see that all the time. And now it's kind of shifted more onto social media. There is still body shaming everywhere. It's not just about being overweight and slim anymore. It's about having like a big bum and big boobs and being curvy. But then what about the girls that have a small bum and a big belly and something like that? There's still like gaps where we talk about body positivity, but there's still people that aren't, do you know what I mean, talked about respectively. Yeah.
Liv, we know it's early where you are. Thank you very much for getting up for us and having a chat.
No worries. Thank you for having me.
it's important to note with that one that that's an indictment on how we treat people, particularly women who are not thin. This is not, I don't think that the answer is that everyone goes and loses weight because you'll be treated better. The answer is that we don't value, we don't put someone's value, sort of index that on their weight. I think that's a really, really sad thing, actually, to discover.
It's massively messed up, right? It's almost like we're being gaslighted by designers as well. If you think about the average size of women in Australia, it's 14 to 16, but most designers don't go past a size 12.
Yeah.
So we're constantly fed this message that bigger or a different shape is bad, and that is just so wrong. We've already got this bully in our head that we're trying to tame. Well, I do. I think most women have that. And, it just, we need to be kinder to ourselves and each other.
Can I just add one important detail to that story, just background, is in Liv's case particularly, and this didn't come out in the interview, but she had like a gastric sleeve, so like weight loss surgery, which is not a cosmetic procedure, that's a health procedure. And I'm presuming now she would have, you know, consulted specialists, there would have been a health reason for that to happen and so on. Like, I would just hate to think there are people watching who would go, oh, right, so I can just do that, or I can just go get surgery and fit. Like, that, the aim wasn't to lose a bunch of weight to, like, go viral.
No.
That wasn't what happened here.
And weight loss often isn't that simple.
No, absolutely not.